Friends, from the thumbnail, you have seen that today's topic is corrective action and preventive action. So before start some technical aspects, some regulatory requirements of corrective action and preventive action. What is corrective action and preventive action? First, listen to a story. It is a very short story, and just I'm trying to correlate to understand the kappa with this story. The story was mine. One day, I find that some gas leakage was occurring from my domestic kitchen. What did I do that time? Hopefully, the similar things you do at your time. At your situation, I did the similar things with my situation. I just opened the windows so that the gas that stuck in my kitchen should be removed immediate basis. After that, I just immediately shut down the connectivity knob of the gas cylinder so that no more gas should come and create a leakage. Third thing which I should do from my instinct, that I shouldn't do any kind of fire that moment, so that it could lead to an accident or incident or create more fatality. So these things what we should do after the investigation or before the investigation to create the remedy of the situation or create the immediate reactions in that situation is called remedial action. That means it is the remedy. Like you think you are facing a fever. So what should you do? You take some medicine immediate basis. If you have some paracetamol, you should take the paracetamol. You can get some ice cubes on your head so that the fever will get down. This is the first remedy. After that, you will visit your doctor to get the reason of that fever. Similarly, for that case, what I do next? I just investigate and find that there was a leakage on that pipeline. So that from that rupture or breakage of the pipeline, the gas was coming out. This was the reason or root cause of that leakage or that incident. So what should I should do? I should do the actions on the root cause so that the root cause or incident shouldn't reoccur is the corrective action. So that I just replace the pipeline and I replace with a new one. It was a corrective action. I just do the necessary correction of the reason of the incident. Now there is another thing. This was the reason for mine. There might be other reasons of the leakage for your case, for others' case, so that all the potential non-conformities that could lead to a leakage of the gas cylinder should be identified. And in a global way, the action should be proposed or should be taken to prevent the occurrence of that root cause or incident in future is called preventive action. That means you can take actions to prevent the leakage in the gas cylinder again. Whatever that 10 reasons, 8 reasons, 5 reasons that could lead to a gas leakage, you take every necessary actions to prevent the leakage again is called preventive action, so that the occurrence of that incident shouldn't do in future again. The kappa is as simple as this. So let's begin with the technical aspects.
Whenever an incident occurs, we do two things simultaneously. One is a reaction to the incident, and other is the interaction requirements related to the incidents. So, first of all, we do the reactive actions. That means reactive approach is based on responding to the events after they have happened, and it's based on the severity and root cause of the incidents. The reactions depends accordingly. Now, interactive is a part which create interaction between two phases. Now, corrective part is actually an interactive part. In the corrective action part, we interact according to the investigation findings, and we try to also find some actions which just do necessary corrections to that situation or incident or event. Another part that is very much important, that is the proactive approach, which focuses on eliminating the problem before they have a chance to be appear in the future. Proactive approach acts by finding different types of potential causes that could lead an incident, similar type of incident in future. So, proactive approaches is the preventive part of Kappa cycle. A closed loop Kappa process enables companies to avoid or minimize the occurrence of the issue, as managers are better able to characterize the problem and assemble the best possible cross-functional team of people to successfully tackle them, defeating the non-conformities. Now, let's understand the closed-loop Kappa system, what actually is. First, signals are detected, then the critical signals are analyzed. After completion of complete analysis, solutions are being implemented, and after implementation of the adequate solution, the solutions are verified whether they are effective or not. If they are found effective, then closed system Kappa system is found satisfactory. If the solution found not satisfactory, then another adequate Kappa is being proposed for the defect again. Six quality system is an inspection model, a model that can help pharmaceutical manufacturer company to comply with CGMP's regulations. The six system of this model refers to our corrective and preventive action, production and process control, equipment and facility control, record, document and change control, material control and design control. These six subsystems held together by the management control. Management control is an interactive, is monitored through management review, and it helps to comply the internal and external customers' requirements with fulfilling the product and services of the organization along with CGMP regulations. Kappa is a quality improvement process in which we do necessary planning. It is actually a value-added process, and in this process, it is a continuous measuring and monitoring is being done on the potential non-conformities which was observed in the quality system, and this action and planning is being performed through subsequent problem identification, necessary correction, root cause analysis, corrective action, by the effectiveness of that correction, and preventive action. This is the subsequent part of the Kappa. Kappa is a quality improvement system which is performed through two loop pathway. One is internal loop pathway, and second is the external loop pathway. Corrective actions requirements is fulfilled through audit findings, non-conformance findings, batch review, management review, that is process review, and internal audit. Second is the external feedback loop. External feedback loop is also very much important, through which the quality and management system is improved. First of all, complaint. Second is the warning letter. Then return. Third party audit. These are the external feedback loop through which the quality system is developed or improved on a day-by-day basis. Let's define corrective action and preventive action along with different regulatory aspects. First of all, ISO 9000 and 2005 says in section 3.6 about the corrective action and preventive action. There have three different definitions. One is for correction, second is for corrective action, and third is for preventive action. Now, what is the correction? The action to eliminate or detected non-conformity is correction. Now, the action to eliminate the cause of detected non-conformity is corrective action. And the action to eliminate the cause of potential non-conformities is preventive action. Let's discuss what mentioned in Code of Federal Regulation related to CAPA. In 21 CFR Part 211.192, GMP clearly covers the CAPA in Code of Federal Regulation, Title 21, Part 820.100, as corrective action and preventive action. Although CAPA are not specifically named in the drug product in CGMP, but 21 CFR 210 and 211, there are requirement that the parallel concept of CAPA is defined. It is clear that the expectation of CAPA have become a very important requirement of current CGMP in pharmaceuticals. There are requirements of 21 CFR 211, that is example 21 CFR 211.160 and 211.192, that parallel the CAPA requirements listed in the medical devices regulations. As we discussed earlier, CAPA is also included in ICH Q10, that is pharmaceutical quality system. In ICH Q10, it was mentioned how it is a correlated and an important element a CAPA is in the quality system. It is a very important tracking management system in our pharmaceutical development, technology transfer, commercial manufacturing, and discontinuation and investigation procedure mentioned in the management requirement and management policy, quality manual also, and it always helps to improve the key performance indicator of the organization in every aspects. System for implementing the corrective action and preventive action resulting from the investigation of following things like complaints, product rejections, non-conformances observed during the manufacturing process, product recall, deviations during internal and external audit, regulatory inspections and their findings, trained from the process performance and the product quality monitoring. CAPA methodology should result in the product and the process improvement and enhance the product and the process understanding. CAPA system directly related with the following development of an organization like pharmaceutical development, technology transfer, commercial manufacturing, and product discontinuation. CAPA is an important as a key functional which always helps to improve the organizational benefit, and it always helps to track how the organization behaves, and its quality improvement is being monitored through the adequate and effective Kappa management system.
Friends, today's topic was just limited to regulatory requirements of Kappa and some basic things related to Kappa. We will discuss in deeply in others episodes of Kappa. So if you like my video, then press the like button, share them, and don't forget to subscribe my channel Dear Technical Gyan, and press the bell icon so that you will get notification of every new uploaded videos. So always be safe, stay safe, always happy, and always live lively. Thank you.